telecast. This evening, we are very much grateful to God for keeping us alive and giving us the privilege to sit at His table one more time to share the Word of God. Can we just say a word of prayer? Father, thank you for tonight. Thank you for giving us the privilege to eat at your table. The Bible says that you have prepared a table before us in the presence of our enemies, the world, all the cohorts of darkness. Father, have not been given the power to hinder our table. And tonight we pray that, Lord, you will speak your very intent to our hearts and fill us with faith from your word. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Tonight I will be continuing the series that we have started on rest. And I want to speak to you briefly on resting your confidence in God. Rest your confidence in God. You can find rest if your confidence is actually in God, because there are so many things that makes some people confident. You can find your confidence in yourself, in your advantages, in your educational ability, in your wealth, in your beauty, in your strength, in your godfatherisms. There are so many things that can give somebody confidence, but all such confidence will not stand the test of time. You see, one of the meaning of rest really is a trustful relationship. The only thing that can give you rest is when you have that relationship with God where your trust can be built, your trust can be embedded, your trust can stay. Like in Isaiah chapter 26 verse 3, the Bible says, "Thou will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind, whose confidence is stayed on him." You see? So having confidence in God is what guarantees your rest in life. Putting your confidence in God is what makes you sure of the future. It's what guarantees the glory of God in your life. Hallelujah. So this is very, very important. Very, very, very important. Now, in that Isaiah chapter 26 verse 3, in the Amplified version, there is a way the Bible puts it. It says, "You will guard him and keep him in perfect peace." In perfect and constant peace, you will guard him. You know, the word that gave me interest, you know, there is the word guard. God will guard you if your interest is in him. And very, very interestingly, the word guard means to keep watch over you. To keep watch over you and all that is yours. When God is guarding you, he guards everything that is of interest to your life. For instance, if he guards you, he's guarding your family, your children, he's guarding your spouse, he's guarding your business, he's guarding everything that matters to your life. You see that? So, the peace translates from you to everything that you own and to everything you represent. That's what makes the confidence we place on God very, very, you know, profiting. Now, in Mark chapter 2, verse 5, I will read from the Amplified version. Mark chapter 2, verse 5. Now look at what the Bible says. He said, "And when Jesus saw their faith," their confidence in God, through him, he said to to the paralyzed man, son, your sins are forgiven you and put away. Your sins are forgiven you and they are put away from you. That is, the penalty is remitted. The sense of guilt is removed. And you are made upright and right standing with God. Look at all the blessings that followed confidence in God. The Bible says, Jesus said to the man that was sick of the palsy, the man that was having disease, that was brought, he said, because of the confidence of the people that brought you. Because at this time, the man couldn't even speak, didn't even know where he was. You know, he was at the point of death. Jesus said, your sins are forgiven, they are put away, they are remitted, and condemnation and guilt taken away from you. Look at all the blessings that follow confidence in God. You see, this will make you know that God enjoys your confidence. God, you make God who He is when you place your confidence in Him. No matter the loudness, the volume, the voice, the voices you are hearing, the voices of the attacks around you, the voices of the economic oppositions, the voices of the problems around your family and your businesses, let your confidence rest in God. And then you hear Jesus saying, son, put away fear, put away everything. Why? Because I am happy that you trust me. Now in Mark chapter 5, verse 34, this is another scripture. Look at what Jesus said. And he said, Jesus said unto her, daughter, your faith, your trust and confidence in me. You see, springing from faith in God, confidence in me came from your faith in God. So that means confidence is always produced from faith that you put in God. So when you don't have faith in God, then you can never produce confidence. You can't. It is your faith in God. It is your understanding of God. It is your knowledge of God that produces confidence. Little wonder why people don't have confidence in God. Because they don't understand God. If there is anything you need, the Bible says, with all your getting in life, get understanding. Understanding of what? Understanding is not abstract. You don't just get understanding of this space or of this sphere. You don't just get understanding, you know, in the abstract form. You get understanding of a substance. And what is that substance? God. You get understanding of God. You study the world. You remember what Jesus said in Matthew chapter 11 verse 28, come unto me, all ye that labor, all ye that are suffering and struggling and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. He said, take my yoke upon you. Take my yoke. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me and you shall find rest. You see, learn of me, meaning study my word. And then rest will come as a result of your knowing me. So Jesus said that as long as you have faith that is producing confidence that you repose on me, he said, I have restored you to health. I have restored you to health. Go in peace and be continually healed and freed from your distressing bodily disease. You see that? What will restore your health is your confidence in God. This is where rest comes. Now, it's very, very, you know, painful when people don't have confidence in God. Because it's your choice. You see, confidence is something you can decide where you place it. You can decide to place your confidence in God. Or you can decide not to place your confidence in God. Perhaps you want to place it on maybe something material. Maybe an advantage you think you have. Maybe on your certificate. Maybe on your expertise. Where is your confidence, by the way? You can trust God and not be entrusted with life. And not be entrusted with prosperity and not be entrusted with joy. You can't trust God and not be entrusted with peace. That's the truth. By the way, when we say prosperity, we are not talking of having all the money in the world. When we say prosperity, we are talking of the tripartite blessing, the blessing that cuts across your spirit, your soul, and your body. You have the spiritual rest, you have the soul, you know, excellence, a good mind. Bible says he has given us the mind of Christ, you know, and then a sound mind. And then you have the bodily rest, which means the absence of sickness and disease tormenting your life. This is the product of confidence. But when you take your confidence and put in something material, or you put your confidence in the advantage you think you have, that's where the problem is. For instance, in Mark chapter 10, verse 24, you know, I want to read that scripture from verse 23. And Jesus looked around. You know, he spoke to a man. The man came to him. He said, "Lord, what good thing can I do to have eternal life?" Jesus said, "Okay, keep the commandments." Because when Jesus was on the earth, they were still under the law. So what did the law say? The law said, "Thou shalt not steal, kill, commit adultery, this, that, that." The man said, "I've done all this from my youth. What do I lack more?" Now, what the man was saying is, "I am above the law. I want to go into grace. I know what you carry." Jesus said, when you come to grace, it's not keeping the law anymore. It is selling everything you have. It is selling your pride. It is selling your ego. It is throwing away everything that makes you, you know, egoistic, and putting everything on me. And that was difficult for the man. So the man went away angrily. Now look at what Jesus now said. Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, "With what difficulty will those who possess wealth and keep on holding it at the expense of following me, at the expense of living all for my sake, enter the kingdom of God? It is impossible for them to enter the kingdom of God when I'm not put first in your life." Meaning, their confidence is resting on their wealth. What is your confidence resting on? Now look at what he said in verse 24. "And the disciples were amazed and bewildered and perplexed at his words. But Jesus said unto them again, 'Children, how hard it is for those who trust, who place their confidence," you see that? "Their sense of safety in the riches." They place their sense of safety, their confidence in riches. Not everybody has riches, but a lot of people have something they place their confidence in. They place their confidence in certain advantages. That's why they don't have rest. God can never give you rest if your confidence is outside Christ. You can be a believer, you are a child of God, but there is something else that is giving you confidence outside Christ, you know, and that will fail you. Jesus said that when such people put their sense of safety, their confidence in their riches, they will never enter the kingdom of God. This is very, very, very dangerous in life to live. So, it is confidence in God's kindness and his willingness that attracts God's attention. Very, very important. It is confidence in God's kindness and his willingness to bless you. His willingness. You having an understanding that God is willing. Not that God is able alone. God is willing to bless me. It will take away frustration. It will put away all forms of unnecessary pressure from your life. When you have this understanding that God is able and God is willing, God wants to bless me, God has in mind to help me, it will take away confidence, you know, it will put your confidence rather in Christ and takes it away from any unnecessary recommendations from the world, from friends, from things, from circumstances around you. Hallelujah. Now, this is very, very important. And I want, for instance, let's see Luke chapter 8, verse 25. I want you to look at the book of Luke, chapter 8, verse 25. Luke, chapter 8, verse 25. He said, and Jesus said unto them, now mind this, why are you so fearful? Where is your faith? And in bracket, he now tells us what our faith is. He said, your trust, your confidence. Where is your confidence that you claim you have in me? You see, where is that confidence?